वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल मेडिलाइट MBBS. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट OPGY एज अ ब्रांच. सो वी विल बी टॉकिंग बोथ द प्रोज एज वेल एज कॉन्स एंड आई विल टेक द मिनिमम टाइम एंड विद मैक्सिमम नॉलेज रिगार्डिंग द ब्रांच. Let's talk about the pros. As a pros, it is a good branch with work satisfaction for those who are interested in the surgical branch. Infertility, high risk obstetrics cases and laparoscopic surgeries. Good options for fellowship. It has a wide scope which are limitless. Obstetrics alone is a whole branch in itself, and then the gynecology, which is a wide reach into infertility, cancer and minimal invasive surgeries. It is an end branch. If you decide to quit reading after MD/MS branch, then really no more specialization required for someone to directly get into working in OPGY, that is high risk obstetrics, fetal medicine, reproductive medicine, minimal invasive gynecological surgery and DM such as genetics to gynecology. Many gynecologists diverts into urogynecology and gyne oncology. Gynecology, well, the sky's the limit. There is a plenty of surgery and numerous innovation enriching the field every year. There are laparoscopic surgeries was pioneered by gynecologists. All the gynecological surgeries from the cyst to fibroid to cancer are now managed laparoscopically. In fact, many gynecologists like to break the barriers and perform most emergencies like ruptured ectopic pregnancy, torsion, ruptured cyst, etc. Robotics in gynec, which has super exciting prospects. So reproductive medicine is a subspecialty which is cutting edges of current favorite of the new generation gynecologist. IVF is challenging. It is a grafting and it's rewarding more than ever before. The scope of infertility management is so large that the specialists from many other branch of medicine involve themselves in IVF treatment. Those who are interested more in lab work go and specialize in embryology and become better clinical embryologists than others who have not done an MD in gynecology. For bottom line, a happy and ending branch. Let's now talk about the cons of OBGYN. It is really a stressful branch. Should be very cautious, calm and composed. More occupational risk to infection. The advantages are so many that the cons get blurred out. So you don't have to complain, as any clinical branch, it requires you to work around the clock and not just the duty hours. There are countless working hours and no sleep. Do obs gyne only if you are driven and want to make a life out of this. Don't do it for your family or the balance or spouse who is a surgeon or anesthetist. Don't do it just because you are a woman. Women are the smartest, brightest, and they are the entrepreneurs. They can handle pressure better than men, and the obs gyne is physically demanding branch. So if you are attending OPD from 9 a.m. in the morning, everyone look primy and proper and can sound polite to all the patient. But it's 2 p.m. pain in the abdomen with spotting which tests you the most. You have heavy OPD till 3 p.m. The labor room was stuffed the whole night. There are patients in ICU and you are surviving on the lunch till now. It's at this hour when it starts you to hurt. So men who are thinking to take OBGY, see, there are some touch issues, but every major institute and now even major private hospitals have men at the hem of the affairs in OBGY. So men do just as well. There are numerous examples. So those boys who like obs gyne but felt unsure about the career and prospectus, relax. I think I have given enough information regarding obs gyne as a branch. So if you know all these pros and cons and even you can handle this branch, then go for it. All the best and thank you for watching.